Renewable energy is very much the future of not just the national energy portfolio, but the world energy portfolio. Turbines that are designed right now, there are three blades, they face the wind, very efficient. Where we have an issue is if we want to build extreme scale wind turbines.
As you get these larger wind turbines, your blades end up becoming more flexible. And if you're upwind, then when the wind comes in and hits those blades, they can curve backwards, and then it can hit that tower and destroy the entire turbine.
We need a turbine that's more resilient and also larger so it can take in even more energy. The palm tree is a fantastic example of something very, very tall, is lightweight, and can bend with the wind. We just took those concepts that nature had already presented to us and adapted our blade design, moved it downwind so it could cone and morph like a palm tree.
These winds that come in, they're more aligned with the blades and they can bend away from the tower. And so then we can make them larger and larger, and that way you can capture more power.
We spent several years designing this. Now we've actually fabricated a prototype. This 10-story tall prototype is located at the National Renewable Energy Laboratory in Colorado, where the winds can be up to 100 miles an hour. So it represents a condition where there's extreme winds that you would have to be resilient against.
As a student at the University of Virginia, I came out to Colorado for these testing to be able to see if this model is going to react as the full-scale rotor would react.
If it performs as good as we think it could and should, we would then go to the next level and produce a turbine that's even larger. The end goal for this is actually to make it into manufacturing and have entire farms producing power at very high efficiency and at very low cost.
Being able to actually see our project go from just us sitting on a computer to having something physically there is super rewarding. We can actually see our work come to life, and it's something that other people in the future will use and learn from.
This could revolutionize wind energy, not just for the state, not just for the nation, but for the world.